And while I was in Brussels, Didi was getting arrested. Yo, listen. You know, before I go into the details, there's two things that I find interesting in this. The first thing is, I'm not a fan of nobody, so I don't put nobody on the pedestal. If you are, if you're a criminal, you get what's coming to you, right? As a criminal. So I don't know. I wasn't there. But it is strange to see people that you admired, you know? And listen, nobody's perfect. Like I always say, don't admire nobody. Like the only people I admire are my parents. And listen, some parents are not even worth admiring. Mine are, but I would say love yourself. Everybody else, I don't know. So even if I like your work and I respect your achievement and I've been inspired by the things you did as a businessman, etc., you know, hey, if you're going down, you're going down. There's nothing I can say. It doesn't make me happy. It doesn't make me unhappy. I'm just like, wow. I'm just like, oh my God. Now, the second thing that I continue to find strange is how happy Black Americans are. I'm just watching this as I'm watching a novella, and it's somebody's father, it's somebody's boyfriend or somebody's boyfriend is somebody that did great and probably bad things as well. I mean, bad things we've seen in someone video, but I don't understand the joy. I'm laughing at the memes and how the internet is going crazy, but I don't see why everybody's so happy. In the meanwhile, I see a bunch of people that I will not name that are walking free, and they are proven pedos and they're here chilling. So I want to go a little bit on a deep dive of what is going on. And then I will go into some business insight to try to have some theories. Joel, man, what up? How you doing? Sabrina, hey, long time. MTV, what up? So listen, the thing is this. First of all, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to and look for Didi. When am I gonna look for Didi's counts of indictments to know what we are talking about? Okay, three counts. Oh Lord, that's way too long. What are DDs in there you go. I need to find a place where That's too long. Give me a second. Yeah, jailed. Washington Post. Don't trust these people. Let's see. Yeah, maybe. I mean, don't trust CNN either, but why not? Oh, let me see. Sips, whatever. All right, so now let's see. Takeaways from the racketeering conspiracy and sex trafficking indictment against Sean Diddy Combs. For decades, the first paragraph of three counts federal indictment against the music mogul Sean Combs lays out in an overarching summary the serious and sprawling allegations against him. For decades, Sean Combs, aka Puff Daddy, aka P. Diddy, aka Diddy, aka P. Diddy, aka Love, the defendant abused, threatened, and coerced women and others around him to fulfill his sexual desires, protect his reputation, and conceal his conduct. The indictment states, to do so, Combs relied on the employees, resources, and influence of the multifaceted business empire that he led and controlled, creating a criminal enterprise whose members and associates engaged in, among other crimes, sex trafficking, forced labor, kidnapping, arson, bribery, and obstruction of justice. Yo. So three counts, racketeering conspiracy, sex trafficking, and transportation to engage in prostitution. If convicted, he faces a sentence up to life in prison. That's crazy. So criminal enterprise with other associate and employees alleges that he hosted drug-fueled freak-offs with victims and sex workers. Not instance of physical and sexual abuse and illuminates what law enforcement found in the March raids of his homes. So what is hein? Quoi? Qu'est-ce qu'elle dit Soumia? Non, c'est pas du baby, mais j'en ai plein chez moi. J'ai trois bouteilles. J'ai toujours trois bouteilles. Tu sais bien que je mets que du baby oil, Soumia. Soumia dit justice for Tupac. Phil, what up? What it do? So listen, what is interesting here to me, right, is that okay, racketeering conspiracy. Because if he falls for that, there's a lot of people that are gonna go with him. Right now, victims and sex workers. The question here is who are the victims and do they believe that? Comment ça, tu en sais rien que je mets du bébé? Bien sûr que tu sais. And so, how do they? I mean, they will, yeah, of course, they will find, ways to see the difference between some and others, but do they say that the sex workers are victims or they are victims as well? Now, how do you prove, especially after all these years, right, that some of the people who were in these orgies were victims? this is what they're gonna have to do. And sex workers, they were paid to come. So the freak-offs occurred regularly and sometimes lasted multiple days. Yo. That's crazy. The events were arranged by Combs and facilitated by his staff and employees, according to indictment. And the employees arranged the travel for victims and sex workers, booked hotel rooms, stocked them with drugs, baby oil, lubricants, and extra linens, cleaned the room afterwards, and gave Combs large sums of cash to pay the sex workers. Okay. Combs also used a sensitive, embarrassing, and incriminating recording that he made during freak-offs as collateral to ensure he can the continued obedience and silence of the victims. Wow, this reminds me of a Zouk artist. Anyway, law enforcement seized guns. Well, okay. I guess in the US you have the right to have guns, right? Freak-off supplies. What are freak-off supplies? Yo! What are freak-off supplies? I would love to know. Apparently, law enforcement seized guns, ammo, drugs, and a huge collection of baby oil, like 1,000 bottles. 1,000 bottles of, more than 1,000 bottles of baby oil and lubricant at his homes. All right. Maybe he did some stock during COVID. I mean, I'm trying to understand why you need 1,000. Because, so I was talking to a singer, right? That I will not say his name, but very famous in France. And he loves to use baby oil with girls. And he was saying, like, for a whole body, you only need, like, I don't know, 10, 15% of a bottle. Like, this is oil. You don't need to use, like, listen, free of your hand like this, you can cover a whole body. Like, if you go, just if you do it for a massage and stuff. So how much bottles do you need is crazy to me. Apparently, they also found tons of dildos and, listen, if you've been in the music industry, especially in the US, and if you know people from the industry, you heard tons of suspicious stories about Puff Daddy. So I'm not shocked, personally. I'm not shocked. And listen, this whole industry is full of demons. And it's not just him. Like, I'm like, you can name a bunch of them. Woody Allen, Polanski, Hefner, like, even artists, other artists, like, they sing it in their songs, Flying My Bitch, whatever. And yeah, there's groupies. And listen, it's not just in the US. Like, I've seen a bunch of things in French rap, Congolese rap, Coupé Décalé, Zouk. Like, the thing is here now, when does it become criminal? When you start abusing people, when you start, I mean, if you pay people to come, listen, if you're into the dominatrix thing or the voyeur thing and you pay people, I guess it's fine. The problem if you drug people and now they hear without knowing, or, you know, women are on GHB, that's different. And if you start filming people to blackmail them, and you start filming other, you know. Yep. Très, très vrai. If you start filming people and using this as blackmail, that's when it becomes dangerous. I mean, that's when it becomes criminal. So I believe that the number of victims isn't clear. Indictment set, lays out offenses against a number of victims, including women and commercial sex workers, but not specify how many. The prosecution letter asking for Combs to be detained before trial note that dozens of victims and witnesses have provided detailed, credible, and corroborated information against the defendant, combining the total of victims and witnesses. In another part of the letter, the prosecution states it has conducted interviews with over 50 victims and witnesses and said that the numbers expected to grow. Lord. U.S. Attorney Damian Williams was vague when asked to clarify the number of victims at a news conference Tuesday. We are intentionally saying multiple, he said. Meanwhile, the sex trafficking charge is based on allegation against a single unnamed victim, one about 2009 to 2018. Well, l'enfant est dans la sauce. C'est chaud. Listen, all right, listen. For me, it's a very, very true, Soumya. It's very. I mean, there's nothing new. That's why I'm not shocked, and I don't understand. I mean, people react the way they want. The whole internet is crazy. The only thing that shocked me in here was 1,000 bottles of baby oil, because I don't understand why you need that much. Now, the question here is, to me, first of all, who are in those tapes? Because depending on who are in those tapes, either they will clean the tapes. Because if you have some powerful people, it's going to depend. Because the feds might use this as a way to go against other people. So either it's going to be Diddy falling alone if he doesn't talk, or taking a plea deal and talk about, tell on other people of the music industry, or it's going to be multiple people being called and being put as accusation, right? Now, it's the US, it's a corrupt country. So depending on who's going to be on those tapes, because we have people are floating photos everywhere, right? People are putting photos everywhere of parties in the Hampton with people, and everybody believe that if you're in a party, if you're in the photo in there, it means that you are in the freak-offs, which is not true. Those are two different things. But because the internet is now going crazy, if there's any photo of you not far from a Diddy property or with Diddy, you've been baby oiled your ass. That's what the internet is thinking now. So I think some people who have been there, listen, a lot of people are very silent. A lot of people, they're like, make it go away. And listen, I've seen a lot of crazy things of that type during my career and on tour. And the good thing that I can say is that I've never been part of these type of things. So if you can say I was there in the same hotel, I'll say, yeah, I was there, because I don't care. I don't feel that if we heard this type of thing about an artist I know, I would be like, oh, yep, and mind my business. So the thing here is that these two. So, yeah, you in this thing where you're looking at this and listen, right now in Paris, we are seeing there's the horrible trial of this man who's, I don't even know his age, but he was drugging his wife every night for 10 years. And he was having people come and rape her, and while she was on GHB, and then when she was having like a chlamydia or whatever, she was asking him, "What are you doing when I'm at work?" So that guy's like evil. You got these type of evil people, and they are everywhere. And then he was saying that, yeah, because she was a little bit racist. I also called multiple black people. I was like, what kind of evil is that to your wife that you have kids with? There's a lot of sick people out there. Now, to me, Didi is what you call an extreme narcissist. I know a few of them, and everything that I'm seeing here and that I'm being told by the news and rumors and blogs and stuff, it fits exactly the behavior of a bunch of the narcissists that I know. I know them, being around some of these fuckers. So, but this one is one with unlimited money. And this is what happens when you have so much money and then you have a whole industry. Because I'm going to say the same thing about R. Kelly. I'm going to say the same thing about Dr. Dre. There's no tapes, so he's lucky. So he's just like staying silent. He's like, oh, Lord, let me sit down somewhere before people remembers me. Like... and a bunch of other people. You have a whole industry that is protecting these behaviors for the Rolling Stones and all these big artists that been living the rock and roll life, right? And then when the shit hit the fan, all of a sudden, everybody's silent because everybody's guilty, from the people that are enabling the behavior to the people that are subjecting themselves to the actions, to the groupies, to the whole thing is a mess. That whole thing, it's a mess. And that's where, when you look at it, you are just asking yourself, on what angle are you gonna attack that person? Because, you know, it's the same thing as when they wanted to attack, to remove R. Kelly's music from Spotify. To me, I was like, well, in this case, you're gonna have to remove everybody else's music, because all of them have some dark stories and some bigger than others, right? A lot of these people are just, yeah, enjoying these parties and money. If you never had it before and you don't have a good education and you don't, and especially fame, those are drugs that just change your way of seeing things and seeing life. Once you have a certain amount of money that we can say unlimited, right? We can say like, once you have, listen, 100 million, because listen, at a point with, before he got, he beefed with Diageo, which is the company that owns Cyroc and Johnny Label and all these brands of spiritual. Before he beefed with those people, probably about money, and they told him, "Oh, we're gonna show you," because I believe this is orchestrated probably by those people. But I mean, and that's after that beef, that the video with, and also, I mean, he should have, when Cassie told him, "Hey, just give me money and let's not, and I will not go public," he should have paid her. But yeah, narcissism, that's how they do. They believe they are bigger than life. And now, yeah, once the cap was out the bag, poof. So like you're saying, Rugiano, money is a pure magnifier of money, fame, all these things. Like it is, it just magnifies who you are. If you have a good education, you had parents that educated you good, listen, you might be a weak person. And if you are a weak person, yeah, you might fall on whatever, drugs, alcohol, sex, and et cetera. Or you might just be like, "No, that's not for me. Like, and I didn't even come here for that. I came here to express myself. I came here for the message. I came here." Everybody come here for their own reason. But when you go, when you get there, you're gonna have, and we've seen it. We are artists, so not only you're gonna have people, all the fake friends, people coming with all types of offers. You're gonna have women coming with, or men coming with all types of offers. Easy stuff that you should have worked for. Money, listen, I'm not saying that 500 or 1,000 euros is a ton of money, but listen, some people in some countries, they have to work a whole month or 6 months, depending on where you are. You have to work a long time to get that money. Now you get that money in 45 minutes of a show in a club. This changes your perspective on money. And if you haven't been educated financially, this can just mess up with your brain and your the way you view the world. And some people will make that money and invest it somewhere or store it somewhere. Some others will be like, "Oh, it's easy. I'm doing this like every 2-3 days. See what I mean?" Okay. Ah. But no, more too late. Deixa lá.
Can you have it?
Come to this. Thank you. So you're gonna end up, you know, in a thing where this gonna mess with your whole system. Now imagine I'm talking to you about people that I've seen a bunch of artists that got messed up in their brains just because they were famous in a little bit of in the Zouk side of Paris to just a little bit of West Indians and Africans. maybe in Martinique, Guadeloupe, Guyane, that's it. And it messed up their brains. And listen, all these people today are poor. They didn't even like buy a house. It was just a moment in time. They were famous for 5 years and they went crazy. So imagine if you multiply this amount of money, fame, people who adore you, put you in a pedestal, you multiply this by 10,000. And now every time you do a show, you make 200,000, 300,000, 400,000. Oh, listen, if you were not ready for that, oh, bro, you're going to be fucked in your head. If you don't have the right people around you, if you don't have people who tell you don't do this, or people that are, you know, that are just taking you to the right place, you're going to be fucked. And that's the problem with all these artists in America. And, oh, listen, and everywhere in the world, they are just here with unlimited access to everything and nobody is stopping them. And you end with these cases. You end with cases like R. Kelly, cases with like this one, cases with a bunch of others who become predators just because, yeah, it's here. And they don't have the education. They are not ready, you know. So